So in this video, I'm going to set up Ubuntu for Angular application development. And the first thing that you're going to need is Node.js. And there are a couple of ways to install Node.js. You could also do something like sudo apt install Node.js. But I would recommend against that. What I suggest is we use Node version manager. And there are many benefits of that. So to install Node version manager, just search for nvm github, let's say. So this is the first link, Node version manager. What it does, it basically lets you install multiple versions of Node and switch them pretty easily. This also does not require you to run sudo for any of the Node related commands, which is going to make your life very, very easy in the long run. So I'm just gonna copy this. When you reach this repository, look for the installing and updating and just copy this link, go to your terminal and paste it. And it's gonna take a second and then it's gonna install this. Okay, so this is installed. You can see it's fairly quick. At this point, if you run nvm, it's probably not going to work. So you just have to exit it and just open terminal again. So now we can see that nvm is accessible. Let's just nvm install. And for now, I'm just going to go with the latest LTS version, LTS, like this. You could also specify a version here, so you could say nvm install 14, that would install node 14. You could also say nvm install v16, all of these variants. You could even specify the exact version that you want. So I'm just going to go with whatever latest LTS support version is available. LTS is basically long-term support, so you're going to keep getting updates and fixes for this version. So it's always safe to just go with the LTS version. And another reason for having NVM is that you'll be able to switch versions pretty easily. Okay, so node 16 is installed. The way to verify is we can do node V. You can see this is 16.16.0. You could also do npm V, and you can see that this is both of these things are working. All right, so node 16 is installed. Let's go to documents. I'm going to install Angular CLI. So npm install hyphen g add angular slash CLI. So you have to remember this command. I'm going to put this in the description of the video. Looks good. Let's do it. All right, so Angular is installed. The way we would know that this is working is we'll just do ng version. Would you like to enable auto completion? This will set up terminal so that pressing tab while typing Angular CLI command will show possible options. Sure, why not? No, there you go. Ng version is going to give me Angular 14. Okay, as you can see, this is Angular 14. Since I'm in my documents folder, I'm just going to go ahead and create a new Angular application. ng new test app. No need of routing at this point. CSS is also fine. Okay, so this has finished. I have to set up Git quickly. So let's do that. All right, so this is looking good. Now at this point, this must have created a directory. So there it is, test app. So let's go to test app. There are 28 files that have been added. We don't care about that at this point. Let's just run this application. And to do that, we're just gonna do ng serve. So this is going to go ahead and build the application and then it's going to serve it. Yep, compiled successfully. That was pretty quick. And just to see if it is working or not, we are going to localhost 4200. There you have it. The application is running. And now we're going to need a code editor. So we can just, for this video, we can just go with the VS Code. So sudo apt install code should probably get us that. Okay, it did not. Sudo snap install code. Okay, so let's download VS Code. Let's click download. So you are probably going to need to install this one, but the system that I'm using is running on an ARM architecture. So if you have any Intel CPUs, you should probably be good. Intel or AMD ones, you should probably be good with the 64-bit. But I'm gonna go with this one. So let me just download this. Okay, so this is downloaded. Once you have downloaded it, you're gonna want to open in terminal and just simply run sudo dpkg -i code. Enter your password. Okay, so I have a few missing dependencies. Sudo apt install -f is gonna install all of those for you. Yep. So now we should be go to install this. So what I did is I just pressed up 2-3 times to get the previous command back, the one that is the dpkg command. So you can just run that command again and it should work. So as you can see, now there are no errors here. Okay, so I'm going to exit that. Let's look for code in the launcher and let's add it to favorites. All right, looks good. Let's launch this. All right, so let's click open folder, documents, test app, open. Yep, trust. And so there we have it. Sure. Angular language service, it is suggesting me to install this, which is good. It's just going to help me with auto completion and stuff like that. So whatever it recommends you for installing with Angular should be good. And I'm probably going to go with Vim also. Okay, so let's look at the folder structure. There we have the files. This is the app component. And if we look here, we can see that the app is running. So as you can see, test app is running. We can just modify that. So let me just look for test app. There you go. So what I'm going to do is just modify something here. Let's say hooray, Angular is running in Ubuntu. And if I save it, what's going to happen is that it is going to reload that page automatically and we'll have the changes here. So from here onwards, you can follow whatever tutorials you guys are following, read through the documentation, how Angular works, how you can develop apps for Angular. But at this point, your Ubuntu is actually pretty much set up for working with Angular applications. All right, so like and subscribe and see you in the next video. Thanks.